Good morning, friends. I welcome you to our channel, We Are One. As you all know, the world is a pluralistic society, globalized village, and we are one. That is our new channel. And today, through this channel, I shall be talking to you about the most burning problem that we are facing at the moment, that is the corona pandemic. And as you all know, we are in the middle of a lockdown, and nobody knows how long this lockdown is going to continue, whether it's going to be extended, lifted, or lifted in phases. That time will tell, depending on the kind of curve that we get, the graph we get about this corona pandemic, vis-a-vis the graph about our economic activities, the health of economies. So with these things, I have come here today, Dr. Vijay Sagar Dheman, in my channel, We Are One, to you. And today I shall be touching upon very briefly few nuances of life that is during and after this corona regime. And what are its nuances and what are the implications for us in future? Well, friends, India is facing the worst pandemic that humanity has ever witnessed in the recent history. The number of cases of coronavirus infections is on the exponential rise despite cumulative efforts put in by citizens and the administration and the government at the center and the states. Despite that colossal efforts to contain this pandemic and minimize its effect on human beings and economy on war footing, the rampant proliferation is not coming under control. The nation is staring at a major human tragedy and a humongous economic recession. The question today is, will the life be same post this pandemic? The unique event of the millennium generates a grotesque picture of desperation, misery, recession, and a permanent damage to our dreams of a prosperous 21st century, paradigms of exorbitant abundance and opulence with the background of a $5 trillion economy. However, defying this gloom, India does have some takeaways as well, which should afford us an opportunity to resurrect our lives into a better living culture preached and purported by our ancient rishis. The same is available in our numerous scriptures, that is Vedas, Purans, Upanishads, etc. This coded lifestyle will lead us to a healthier and richer beings with much higher levels of satisfaction. We were made to believe that all our ancient systems are only a myth, and the actual meaning of progress came to a world only post-industrial revolution from the West. But that's not true. Now, what is the current situation? Today, the immediate imperative is to fight the war against COVID-19 virus. The war is being fought by nation with a medical fraternity of doctors, paramedic staff at the helm, supported by others like security personnel, logistics chain personnel, and the government administration. In this fight against coronavirus, we need to take immediate proactive steps. They are to ensure enough availability of PPEs, that is protection equipment, masks, including N95 masks, ventilators, and testing kits. The industry in private sector, public sector, or even defense should be urged upon with incentives to ensure that not only domestic demand is made up, but we should be able to export as well for our future diplomatic gains. The monumental increase in production capacity of drugs like hydroxychloroquine and paracetamol, etc., are a case in point. The administration at all levels must ensure medical protection to medical doctors, providing them with requisite equipment like protection equipment, N95 masks, etc. These doctors and paramedics are our revered corona warriors, and enough testing kits and testing drugs, treatment drugs, and vital medical equipment must be made available to them to treat patients. Enough hospital beds should be requisitioned for the chronic patients. Schools, stadiums, hostels, railway coaches, and the other community centers should be equipped with adequate facilities to quarantine and test, treat the mild to moderate patients. Physical protection against goons, the violators of discipline, and intimidators should be ensured for all medical staff. Finally, the nation should go down in front of these corona warriors in gratitude wherever they are seen. Secondly, the nation must look after its daily wages and the migrant workers in our unorganized sectors who are jobless due to the closure of industry, services, and the routine handiworks because of imposition of lockdown. It is the responsibility of the nation to ensure that this set of citizens is not abandoned just because we do not have a formal data about them. These daily wages are the backbone of India's services sector, which has a predominance in contribution to our GDP. At this crucial situation of complete lockdown, the compensatory wages must flow into the bank accounts, whether from employer or from the government, to survive. It may not be possible for India to follow USA and other EU nations' model, wherein US has announced $2 trillion package for giving $1,200 to each registered citizen. What the government of India can do is to ensure that a shelter, that is the Ranbaseras, or two meals and a sanitized environment for those workers to hang around till the lockdown lasts. Any infirmity in the arrangement by administration on this will lead to the exodus of migrant workers to their natives or for search of a job, defeating the purpose of lockdown and promote transmission of COVID-19. Thirdly, as 90% of our population is homebound today, the nation must initiate an immediate action to ensure that supply of food items and the FMCGs is not interrupted. There is an urgent need to ensure that the production of food items, including all FMCG items required in daily life, is not hampered. The supply chain of these items is efficiently regulated by the administration to avoid any kind of shortages or even hoarding tendencies. The essential items must reach the consumers smoothly at their doorsteps. The administrations need to study the bottlenecks of the entire chain, and each bottleneck has to be cleared in a deliberate manner, ensuring full safety of the workforce involved in it, following the tenets of social distancing and other forms of protection. This must take into account all stages, from the crop harvesting in the fields or goods manufactured in the large industry or MSMEs must reach the storage houses, distribution points, and the retail outlets. The selective retail outlets should be given responsibility to ensure doorstep delivery on phone or an e-platform. To ensure this, the administration will have to ensure that a foolproof and corona-safe transport policy is in place with adequate corona-safe guards. Now, what happens once this is over and we are into a stage which is post-corona pandemic scenario? Well, once the fight against coronavirus is on, the nation needs to prepare for post-corona scenario as well. The post-corona scenario may not be the same as pre-corona fate. However, the lessons this crisis has brought to the fore have to be seriously studied and acted upon for future calamities. Well, in this regard, firstly, the major drawbacks in our healthcare systems have been exposed. All shortcomings should be documented, and there should be a task force to study the lessons thrown up by this disaster to formulate a renewed healthcare system involving private sector, government departments, NGOs, and the charity organizations. And even all the religious organizations, irrespective of religion, are cash rich. They must be asked to follow RSR, that is religious social responsibility, on the lines of corporate social responsibilities to run charity hospitals for economically weaker sections of society with state-of-art equipment. They can also reap the benefits of medical tourism from the patients from foreign countries for remaining viable on the lines of the corporate hospitals as well. Secondly, a task force should be organized at Niti Aayog in conjunction with the Commerce Ministry and other relevant departments to identify, document, and assess the daily wages workers in informal and unorganized sectors. Measures to improve their work culture must be put in place. that technology should be used in terms of Aadhaar, Jan Dhan Yojana, and e-bank accounts, etc. They should be made compulsory to give them monetary benefits from the government. Thirdly, a task force comprising of agricultural ministry and relevant departments of commerce ministry and consumer forums should be made to study the supply chain system reforms at all individual stages. They should be suggested and implemented so that farmers are facilitated to produce more and then their earnings are not hijacked by the middlemen. The transport system, the short storage facilities, and accounts of earnings should also be streamlined to ensure greater efficiency. Well, let's now see what are the discarnate advantages of this away from what is happening in the country. In this leisure time forced upon us by the forced lockdowns, we all should relax, cool our minds, enrich our souls, and introspect about our inefficient mechanical life. Our introspection about our own business, about our own life, that will lead us to recognize the pitfall into our inefficient dealings, superfluous and infructuous transactions that we do every day. This would increase the productivity, add spice and zing to our lives. Well, we should thank the lockdown for bringing us close to nature and pollution-free atmosphere, clear waters and clear sight of mountain ranges with beautiful chirping birds around us. This has afforded us to spend time with our families, spend time at home playing caroms, ludos, cards, table tennis, and cracking jokes with our children. So guys, we are in the middle of a problem. We are in a severe disaster, but we should remain positive, not lose our head, and we should always try to look for the benefits every crisis gives us. The positivities the crisis gives us. They say every cloud has a silver lining. Similarly, this one has also had. So I'll sign off today with a saying, a very famous saying by the Winston Churchill. That is what he said after the Second World War. He said, every calamity, every disaster throws up certain positivities, certain lessons, and we should take full advantage of all those. So guys, cool yourself. Do not go against the nuances of lockdown. Do not step out. Do not allow this corona to be transmitted to everybody else. And make sure that you follow all the cleanliness norms. Make cleanliness of your hands, your sanitization, your environments. Make them safe. Make them clean. Make them a part of daily life. And make sure they continue as a habit with you hereafter, even after this disaster ends. And above all, do not forget social distancing and use the N95 mask if possible, or even homemade masks which you can make at home and use them. Whenever you move out, you should never move out without a mask. So thank you very much for patiently listening to me. Goodbye, Jai Hind and Jai Bharat.